Did you know that it's possible to intercept traffic from a phone and see what your applications are sending and receiving? In this example, I've got an Android phone connected to my Wi-Fi network. I've also got this laptop connected to the network. And on the laptop, I'm running Burp Suite, which allows me to intercept traffic sent by this phone. On the laptop, I'm running Burp Suite. So what I'll do here is enable interception. So intercept is on. On the phone, I will open the McDonald's app. So that's now started. And as you can see there, traffic is being intercepted. We see traffic going to Facebook, which is interesting. You can see here's an example that traffic is being sent to McDonald's.com. We've got GraphQL, execute JSON, Great Britain, because I'm in England, English language. It's sending information to McDonald's, telling it that I'm using an Android phone. Whole bunch of information is sent. Nothing is happening on the app at the moment because I haven't forwarded this traffic to McDonald's. So if I select all the traffic and then click forward, we should see something happen on the app. What I'll do is turn off interception so that it's no longer stopping traffic being sent. And there you go, the app has updated. We can see information about McDonald's there. If I go to HTTP history, we can see that a whole bunch of traffic was sent by the phone. If I go to dashboard as an example, we can see McDonald's here. So notice there was a GET request to McDonald's and some information was sent back. So we can see information with regards to breakfast, whole bunch of information sent to the phone. What I'll do is go back to proxy and turn interception on, go to more, nutrition information. Let's have a look at burgers as an example, and let's have a look at a quarter pounder. Information is being requested, but nothing's being sent at the moment because I'm capturing it. So I'll forward that information through. We can see quarter pounder with cheese here. Nutrition information is shown there. If I go back to HTTP history, notice here, we told a quarter pounder patty of 100% beef with two slices of cheese. And that's what we see right over here on the phone. So we are seeing the information being sent to McDonald's on the left, so request, and then the information sent back. So under ingredients, we see this kind of information. So ingredients, we can see 100% pure beef. And then we've got wheat flour here. We can see the image that was loaded, etc. If I ran a browser on the phone and I go to a website, let's say davidbomble.com, we'll be able to see that kind of information here as well. So notice HTTPS, davidbomble.com, the Android phone using the Chrome web browser is requesting information from the server, and a bunch of information is returned by the server saying, David Bomble, start learning today and change your future. And that's what we see over here. So Burp Suite allows us to intercept traffic from a browser, as an example, or an application. Now you do have to do some setup for this to work. In Burp Suite, you have to go to proxy settings and you have to add the interface that you're going to capture traffic from. So in my example, I used that IP address and this port number 8080. And I clicked add and that allowed me to capture traffic. On the device, so the phone as an example, under your network, so as an example, your Wi-Fi network, you have to configure your proxy server IP address and port number. So that matches what I've got configured in Burp Suite. And that then allows me to capture the traffic. Now, another thing you'll have to do is browse to the IP address of your Burp Suite server and the port number. In my example, it's 192.168.0.247 port 8080. And you'll have to install the certificate. So you'll have to install it using, for instance, the certificate installer and install the certificate on your phone. That will then allow you to capture traffic. I'm not going to show the full process on how to install the certificate. That often depends on your phone. But if you browse to your Burp Suite IP address and add it to your device's trust store, that will allow you to capture traffic. So on the Burp Suite website, they tell you that you have to install your certificates, but they're not going to show you this for every single phone because it really depends on the version of Android you're using as an example or which phone you're using. But you've got to install the certificate on your device. So have a look at the Burp Suite documentation on how to do that. Now, I found that this works really well for a browser. It doesn't always work for apps. Depends on the version of Android that you're using. I'll show you in a separate video how to install the certificate in the root of the Android phone. because that's a separate process. What you'll find as an example is some apps will not work because they'll complain about the SSL certificate. Your browser will work fine using a very basic setup like this, and some applications like McDonald's will work fine. Other applications will not work. I'll turn Intercept back on and let's open another app, let's say Gmail. I'll send an email to myself. I'll make this test to email and just say the message is test and I'll send the email. Notice it says sending at the moment. It's not able to send it because I am capturing all the traffic. So I've got to forward all that traffic to allow the email to be sent. So I'll click forward for all of these messages. And there you go, the message is now being sent. I've sent it to myself so I could read that message as well. So here's an example, you can see request messages. I'll turn Interception off. And there you go, I can check my email as an example.